Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Avery, and these are all of the ebooks that I ended up downloading in January. So, I downloaded 33 books in January. I think I only paid for one of these books, and I borrowed or got all the other ones for free. So, I'm gonna tell you about those books today. If you've never seen an ebook haul from me, I normally just read the summary word for you because I personally don't know anything about these books, so I'm just gonna read the summary for you. So let's get started, shall we? First book that I have is Stormy Love by Lexi Timms. This is still available to purchase for free. On her wedding day, Ava finds her fiance messing around with his best man's wife. Stranded at the altar, she manages to collect herself. Humiliated and angry, she decides to go on her honeymoon. Alone. It's already paid for, so why not? She swears off rich man for the rest of her life. The hunk offering scuba lessons seems the perfect distraction. Short term, no strings. Why shouldn't she spend her honeymoon making love? It may not be with her husband, but then again, she isn't wearing a ring. Then I downloaded Den of Vipers by K.A. Knight off of Kindle Unlimited. Writer Garrett Kenzo and Diesel, the Vipers. They run this town and everyone in it. Their deals are as sordid as their business, and their reputation is enough to bring a grown man to his knees, forcing him to beg for mercy. They're not people you mess with, yet my dad did. The old man ran up a debt with them and then sold me to cover his losses. Yes, sold me. They own me now. I'm theirs and ever since the word, but I've never been meek and compliant. These men, they look at me with longing, their scarred, bloody stained hands holding me tight. They want everything I am, everything I have to give, and I won't stop until they get just that. They can own my body, but they will never have my heart. The Vipers, I'm going to make them regret the day they took me. Then I downloaded To Seduce a Highlander from Kerrigan Byrne. It's a collection of the Clan MacLachlan Berserkers. I cannot pronounce that. You could download this off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for $3.99. So yes, this is a collection of the Berserkers, Roderick, Connor, Finn, and their three stories. It says, they are three of the world's unwanted. On a snowy solstice night, their tale becomes one of blood, vengeance, love, redemption, and forging the bonds that make a family. Then I downloaded The Alien Assassin's Convenient Wife by Ruby Dixon. I downloaded this off of Kindle Unlimited. One half of an intergalactic assassin team, Jad Zion, heads to New Mexico for his target while his brother, Hurriot, heads to California. They've traveled millions of miles and through star systems to find their targets, who are gun runners on a galactic scale. Now, though, Jad Zion has a problem. He's waited until the last minute to go planetside, and his target's at a couple's retreat. Jad Zion is solo. The solution is obvious. Jad Zion needs a wife, just for the weekend, of course. Using a thing called a dating app, he finds a woman named Jenna. He tells her he needs to marry her right away. Jenna, naturally, is confused, but the longer she's around Jad Zion, the more she thinks he's not around from around here and that he might just be the one for her. Then I downloaded The Princess and the Pawn, a Raven and Dove prequel novella by Caitlin Davis. This is still available to download for free. So this is just, it says, a novella before The Raven and the Dove, and I've heard great things about Raven and the Dove. And so it basically says, a princess longing to be free, a bastard aching to belong. Fate brought them together and our destiny will tear them apart. So there's only 51 pages, a little novella about them. I haven't read that book yet though, the full-length one. Next we have The Alien Warrior's Mate, a sci-fi alien romance by Nilia Alarcon. I'm so sorry if I'm butchering that. This is available off Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $3.99. I'm being sold to the highest bidder in outer space. That's a sentence I never thought I'd say. But there's no way I'm going down without a fight. These evil jerk aliens will sell me over my dead body, which is something they seem rather eager to do, until a hot blue alien with tattoos and purple eyes steals me away from the auction. His touch makes me tremble, and not from fear. But my alien rescuer has a secret, and I might not survive when it's revealed. Can I trust my own heart, or will this alien be the death of me? Then I downloaded a boxed set, which was The Court of the Underworld, a paranormal romance Greek Gods series by Alyssa Thorne. I read the first book in this series, and so I got the box set for free one day. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $5.99 as a box set. This box set collects the first four books of The Court of the Underworld, with each book a dangerously sexy, fast-paced paranormal romance and featuring Hades and the members of his court. Follow them as they war against their enemies and find that even monsters can get their happy endings. Then I downloaded Once Upon a Dream by Sierra Simone. This is still available to download for free. So this book is a collection of fairy tale novellas. So first one is Music Box Girl, which is a 12 Dancing Princesses story. The second one is titled American Witch, which is a Princess and the Pea story. And then the last one is Red and White, which is a Snow White and Rose Red story. So each of those are fairy tale retellings. Then I downloaded The McKinnon's Bride by Tanya Ann Crosby. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $3.99. When Laird Ian McKinnon's young son is captured by the English, the fierce Scottish chieftain retaliates in kind, capturing the daughter of his enemy to bargain for his son's return. Fiercely loyal to kin, Ian never imagines any father could deny his child, or that would become Paige Fitzsimon's savior. Keep her or kill her, Fitzsimon proclaims when Ian forces his hand. So what else should a lad do but carry the lass home without telling her the truth? Her father doesn't want her. But even as Paige blames her reluctant champion for welching on a bargain with her father, she suspects the truth. The shadows hold secrets and danger. Now only love can save McKinnon's fiery new bride. Then I downloaded The Duke I Tempted by Scarlett Peckham. I ended up buying this one. I actually bought two then. So I bought this one as well. He's controlled, meticulous, immaculate. No one would expect the proper Duke to be a member of London's most illicit secret club, least of all, his future wife. Having overcome financial ruin and redeemed his family name to become the most legendary investor in London, the Duke of Westmead needs to secure his holdings by producing an heir, which means he must find a wife who won't discover his secret craving to spend nights on his knees or make demands on his long scarred over heart. Poppy Cavendish is not that type of woman. An ambitious, self-taught botanist designing the garden ballroom in which Westmead plans to woo a bride, Poppy has struggled against convention all her life to secure a hard-won independence. She wants the capital to expand her exotic nursery business, not a husband. But there is something so compelling about Westmead, with his starchy bearing and impossibly kind eyes, that when an accidental scandal makes marriage to the Duke the only means to save her nursery, Poppy worries she wants more than the title he's offering. The arrangement is meant to be just business, a greenhouse for an heir, but Poppy yearns to unravel her husband's secrets and to tempt the Duke to risk his heart. Then I downloaded off of Kindle Unlimited Married to Krampus by Marina Simcoe. You could also either buy this for $3.99 if you don't have Kindle Unlimited. My husband has horns, hooves, fur, and a tail. His Krampus-like appearance didn't scare me away from marrying him. Forever an optimist, I eagerly agreed to be the first bride shipped under the new liaison program to Vorin, a country on the newly discovered planet Neuron. The colonel also has two little boys, a huge plus for me since I adore children. My down-to-earth sister says I live with my head in the clouds, and maybe I naively hoped for an out-of-this-world romance. What I didn't expect was an out-of-this-world brute. The scowling, growling, rough around the edges colonel proves hard to live with and impossible to love. He's also proud and possessive and is dead set on keeping me as his wife. There is something behind the scowl of this infuriating man, though, that intrigues me. Catching glimpses of his strong, fur-covered body makes my stomach flutter with excitement. I came to Voron hoping to find my place in its culture and in the colonel's heart. Could there be a way to make this thing work between us? Then I downloaded Blind Love by Leon M.A. Edwards. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for $3.99. An introvert millionaire lives inside a large mansion with 15 bedrooms in Bel Air, Los Angeles. He lives with his parents, siblings, and their respective families. He writes novels about falling in love that he can only dream about in his imaginations. He has held a torch for a woman he has known since elementary school. She is a renowned surgeon that has never noticed him and is engaged to be married. She becomes blind when she is in a car accident. Her cheating fiancé has no time to look after her due to business commitments. The opportunity arises at his lavish seasonal garden party. Can he help her overcome blindness while hiding his strong infatuation for her? Can She See Through Her Blindness that he is the right one for her? Then I ended up downloading Soothsayer by Canada Jackson. This is still available to download for free. Salome was raised in a fundamentalist community. She is being courted by the head of the church and has done little more than hold his hand as prescribed by their rules. She wears the uniform on her body and obeys their rules with all her heart, terrified that any deviation will cause the loss of her salvation. She has been taught that she needs to hide things that make men desire her. Men were hapless. They reacted to a woman's wiles despite their desire for goodness, and the quest for modesty and sobriety rested solely in her hands. She denies everything cardinal that simmers within her and succumbs to manipulation and control that borders on abuse. A chance meeting throws her into a world of the Nephilim, where she meets a half-demon named Braith, who is the opposite of everything she has been taught. He is beautiful, powerful, and empowering. He sweeps Salome off her feet and shows her that the line between good and evil is sometimes blurred. She yearns to be free from her community and the indoctrination of her strict upbringing, and considers joining his coven of half-demon warriors who are about to embark on a war against their evil brethren. But that would mean becoming an immortal and equally powerful daughter of the night, and this would bring a whole new set of challenges. Then I downloaded The Fae Lord's Companion Part 1 by Lisa Kumar. This is still available to download for free. 6 years ago, a Fae raid stole away Lena's parents. Since then, she's managed to scrape together a decent life with her grandparents. But that happy, simple life is shattered the day the arrogant Sidhe Lord who took her parents returns and claims her as his mistress. Though she vows to never stop plotting for her freedom, she can't deny the otherworldly pull between them. Lena, the human that the Fae Lord Gabrion couldn't forget. Though something in her spirit had sparked his cold soul, Gabrion knows too well that heartache attachments can bring. When he sees Lena again, he can no longer ignore the longing she ignites in him. Though claiming her goes against everything he was brought up to believe, he takes her as his companion. During the day, she holds herself away from him. At night, however, she flares to life in his arms. As a human revolution ferments, his growing relationship with Lena becomes even more perilous as enemies seek to use her against him. Will he be able to earn her forgiveness and love, or will they both perish before either of them has a chance to achieve what they long for? Gabrion, his redemption, and Lena, a sense of freedom. Then I downloaded Forever Mine by Kennedy Fox. This is still available to download for free. It's been 10 years. He hasn't stopped loving her for 1 second. Seeing the woman who broke my heart a decade ago is something I'm not prepared for. Though I've forgiven Savannah, I've never forgotten what she did. Now it's time to confront the secret she kept from me. Though it won't be easy, I'm determined to make things right between us. One night together is all it takes for our feelings to come rushing back. As memories of us flood in, truths are finally revealed. When the present collides with our past, I'll do anything to win her back, even when Savannah tries to run again. This time, I'll stop at nothing for a second chance. Then I downloaded Edge of Eon by Anna Hackett. You could download this off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for $2.99. Sub-Captain Eve Trainer knows a suicide mission when she sees one. With deadly insectoid aliens threatened to invade Earth, the planet's only chance of survival is to get the attention of the fierce Eon warriors. But the Eon want nothing to do with Earth, and Eve wants nothing to do with the abducting war commander Davion Than Eon off his warship. But when Earth's Space Corps threatens her sisters, Eve will do anything to keep them safe, even if it means she might not make it back. War Commander Davion Than Eon is taking his first vacation in years. Dedicated to keeping the Eon Empire safe, he has been born and bred to protect. But when he's attacked and snatched off his very own warship, he is shocked to find himself face to face with a bold, tough little Tyrian warrior, one who both infuriates and intrigues him. When their shuttle was attacked by the ravenous insectoid Kantos, Eve and Davion crash land on the terrifying hunter planet known as Hunter 7, a planet designed to test a warrior to his limits. Now the pair must work together to survive. Caught between the planet and its dangers, the Kantos hunting them down and their own incendiary attraction. Then I downloaded Bodyguard, a werewolf shifter paranormal romance by Kiara Blackwood. This is available off Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $2.99. She deserves better, but fate doesn't care. I get the trash missions, the kind of crap an errand boy would handle. So when I'm called to do a transport, I'm not surprised until I see her. She has class and curves, not to mention legs for days. Even on the run for our lives, it's Alex who challenges me, who keeps me on my toes. This isn't the mission I expected. It's so much more. She's more. Alex is stuck with me as her bodyguard, but I know it's more than that. Alex is my mate, or she will be if we can work together long enough to survive. Then I downloaded Titanic by I.D. Johnson. This is still available to download for free. Meg never dreamt she would find herself aboard Titanic, dressed in the borrowed clothes of her lady-in-waiting, hiding from her family, running from her haunting past. Now that she finally has the opportunity to escape it all, she realizes the man she has been engaged for 3 years is also aboard the ship. Their marriage was arranged by their fathers long ago, and since they've always had the Atlantic Ocean between them, Meg is able to conclude her charade. However, if Charlie discovers her true identity, she will end up breaking his heart all over again. And the more Meg spends time with Charlie, the more she realizes she made a terrible mistake. She never should have ran away from him to begin with. Will Meg find a way to reveal her true identity without destroying their blossoming relationship? Or will her last chance at love end up in the abyss? Next, I have On the Edge by Joanna Mazakuriewicz. I'm so sorry, I'm butchering that. This is available to download for $3.99. To escape her difficult past, Sasha jumps into an opportunity of managing the sale of the stylish upmarket apartment. All sounds like a dream, but no one had ever mentioned the arrogant, mouthy Scottish god that lives next door. The problem is that Dexter isn't just good looking, he's also a fist-clenching, heart-pounding, fervent, hot man who makes her heart flutter uncontrollably. With the talent of melting women's panties off at a glance, he thinks he can have Sasha too. Well, he couldn't be more wrong. Sasha would rather eat dirt than sleep with him. He vows not to fall for her, but their scorching attraction proves impossible to ignore. Then we have Every Breath You Take, a Single Mom Romance by J.E. Parker. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for $2.99. I'm a single mom with a past darker than coal. I've endured a life of pain, escaped a monster, and survived hell. Because of my past, the walls surrounding my heart are strong, impenetrable. But those walls begin to crumble when I meet him. Detective Anthony Moretti. He's everything I've ever wanted and everything my son deserves. I can lie to myself all day long, but the truth is I want him. But we don't always get what we want, do we? With the monster from my past closing in, I pushed him away. But Anthony, hard-headed man that he isn't having it. Hell-bent on staking his claim, he won't give up. No matter how hard I push, he doesn't budge. As far as he's concerned, my fate is sealed. But the monster from my past still lurks. And whether I'm ready or not, it's about to rear its ugly head. Then I downloaded Mary Incubus by Talia Hibbert off of Libby. But you could purchase this for $2.99. Cash Evans knows exactly what he wants for Christmas. Too bad he can't have her. The infamous tattoo artist's been watching geeky Bailey Cooper for months. That's all he'll ever do. Watch. Bailey's too sweet, too smart, too good for the likes of him, and he knows it. So Cash keeps his distance until a Christmas miracle makes him Bailey's boss. Socially awkward Bailey learned long ago that men just aren't worth the hassle. Take her new boss, Cash. He's a brooding beast who avoids her like the plague, but he also fixes her plumbing, helps the homeless, and offers Bailey a place to stay for Christmas. She never met anyone so confusing or so impossible to resist, but the more Bailey learns about Cash and his demons, the more she thinks it's time to stop fighting. Then we have Be My Spark by Nia Arthurs. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase this for $3.99. Jonas Greer. They call him a basketball prodigy. To me, he's nothing more than a cold-hearted jerk. Our friendship used to be my North Star, my world, my everything. Now it's just a bitter reminder of how much he hurt me. Between hooking up with his adoring groupies every weekend, crushing hearts, jaws, and college basketball records, Jonas always finds the time to torment me. I clap back, refusing to cower, never expecting to be paired with him for an entire summer. But here we are, meeting in the back of the library, his hands brushing mine, his thigh pressed against my leg. They say that there's a fine line between love and hate, and there is. But it's a line Jonas and I will never cross. Not with that awful secret simmering between us. Jonas thinks he can turn our spark of chemistry into a fire. What he doesn't know? Giving into that blaze will destroy me. The second book that I ended up buying in January was The Ippos King by Grace Draven, the third book in the Wraith King series. I'm not really gonna say the summary for this one because it kind of like spoils what happens in the previous book, so I'm not gonna read the summary, but this is a fantasy romance series. So then we have The Undying King by Grace Draven, which I also borrowed off of Libby, but you could purchase this for $2.99. The stories are told in whispers, even after so long, of a man whose fair rule soured when he attained eternal youth. Imprisoned by a sorceress wife in a city out of time and place, he has passed into legend. Few believe in him, and even fewer would set their hopes on his mercy. But Imogen has no choice. To break the curse that's isolated her since birth, she'll find the Undying King and answer his secrets with her own. Then I downloaded off of Libby A Light Within, A Winter's Tale. This is a 18-page novella connected to the Master of Crows series by Grace Draven. So I'm not going to read the summary because it'll spoil it probably. And then same thing with The Lightning God's Wife by Grace Draven. I downloaded off of Libby, and it is connected to the Master of Crows series, so I'm not going to spoil that for you, so I'm going to not read you the summary for that one. But you could purchase both of those for 99 cents if you would like. Then I downloaded Rejected by Jamin Eve. I downloaded this off Kindle Unlimited, but you could purchase it for $3.99. As a wolfshifter growing up in a strong pack, I should be living my best life, but after my father tried to kill our leader, I am labeled an outcast, traitor, less than dirt. When I can't take pack life any longer, I run, but apparently they didn't like losing their punching bag. Torin, the leader's son, drags me back before my first shift, a shift that will reveal my true mate. I never could have predicted who mine would be, but the moment my wolf looks upon him, I am filled with hope for a brighter future. After all, no one rejects their true mate, right? Wrong. Very wrong. When the wolves attack, my soul screams for vengeance, and somehow I touch the shadow world. Somehow I bring him to our lands, the shadow beast, our shifter god, the devil himself. Turns out being rejected by my mate was only the beginning. Then I downloaded Kings of Mayhem by Penny D. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for $3.99. Cade. I have loved her since we were 5 years old. We grew up side by side, two kids tied together by the King of Mayhem's motorcycle club. But I broke us. I broke her, so she fled. Now she's back after 12 long years, and I'm going to show her all the reasons why we should be together and make her forget all the reasons why we shouldn't. Indy. I'm back in town, but only because I have to be. I'm here to help my mother bury my father. And the sooner we get done, the better, because I want to see Cade as much as I want a hole in the head. He broke me once. No, he broke my everything, and I'll be damned if I'd let him do it again. Get in, get out. That's the plan. But you know what they say about best laid plans. Then I downloaded Curvy Girls Can't Date Quarterbacks by Kelsey Sterling. Oh, Stelting, sorry. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $9.99. I'm a big girl, plus sized, whatever. I'm sick of hearing about it, especially since my doctor diagnosed me with PCOS. So when mean girl Merritt shot her mouth off about how fat people should just lose weight, I couldn't take it anymore. And now I've got a huge problem. To prove curvy girls like me can get happily ever afters too, I have to get our school's quarterback, Beckett Langley, to take me to homecoming. He doesn't even know I exist. But it's not hopeless. Four other girls just like me are willing to help, because enough is enough. I will not lose this bet. Then we have King of Lies by Whitney G. This is still available to download for free. I don't have much time to reveal all the details, but I will say this. The woman disappears after her wedding, and woman flees after honeymoon. Headlines are lying. I'm not missing. I didn't run away after my wedding. I would have never run away right after our amazing honeymoon. My husband has taken me. He's kidnapped me because he claims that it's what's best, that I'm a mere pawn in his twisted game of chess, despite the fact that my heart is still tethered to his, or the fact that he's the most gorgeous and beautiful man I've met in my life. I have to focus on getting away from him. I have to accept that he's no longer the man I fell in love with. He's the king of lies. Then I downloaded another box set, which was Cavern of Pleasures box set by E.M. Brown. All it says is intrepid, I cannot pronounce that word, heroines and wickedly hot noblemen turn up the heat in this collection of three historical romance novels, sure to scorch up your reading. And lastly, I have The Foxhole Court by Nora Savak. I don't know how to pronounce that. I'm so sorry. I'm horrible. This is still available to download for free. Neil Jostin is the newest addition to the Palmetto State University XC team. He's short, he's fast, he's got a ton of potential, and he's the runaway son of the murderous crime lord known as The Butcher. Signing a contract with the PCU Foxes is the last thing a guy like Neil should do. The team is high profile, he doesn't need sports news broadcasting pictures of his face around the nation. His lies will hold up only so long under this kind of scrutiny, and the truth will get him killed. But Neil is not the only one with secrets on the team. One of Neil's new teammates is a friend from his old life, and Neil can't walk away from him a second time. Neil survived the last 8 years by running. Maybe he's finally found someone and something worth fighting for. So there you have it. Those are the very many, many books that I downloaded in the month of January. Please let me know down below if you have read any of these books or if you plan to. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.